Chapter 494, Arrogance. Qin Lai got to his feet and looked at Huang Zilai standing in the distance. After a moment of thought, he actually chose to stroll in her direction. I cultivate the blood spirit art. What are you going to do about that? The thick stench of blood emanated from every pore in Qin Lai's body as he spoke. The stench soon took a more solid shape as it transformed into a thin veil of blood mist and enveloped Qin Lai. At the same time, Qin Lai's eyes became as red as blood, the very image of murder. Huang Zilai were suddenly at a loss for words. The martial practitioners of the Black Voodoo Cult and three great families were also dumbfounded. Not only did Qin Lai not deny the accusation, he even decided to prove it on his own. This turn of events was completely beyond their expectations. What exceeded their expectations even more was the fact that Qin Lai actually dared to proudly walk toward them by himself. An evil remnant of Blood Fiend sect. He actually cultivates the Blood Spirit art. He dares to admit it. The martial practitioners of Celestial Artifact sect and 10,000 Beast Mountain were overcome with surprise as they watched him with odd expressions. Blood Fiend sect? They're both from Blood Fiend sect? Hi Wei's expression became ice cold as she disdainfully said, no wonder the two of them fooled around with each other. They're evil remnants of Blood Fiend sect. Aren't the people of Blood Fiend sect public enemies in the land of chaos? Ren Peng laughed cruelly. We have a show to watch, Hu Ping said with a grin, eyebrows raised. The three great families have never stopped hunting down evil remnants of Blood Fiend sect. They practically stomped all over Blood Fiend sect's corpse in order to stand tall in the heavenly calamity continent. Hey! How would they possibly let a member of Blood Fiend sect roam free? Hi Wei, Ren Peng, Hu Ping, and Wei Liang took joy in Qin Lai's misfortune. As matters were, they no longer treated Qin Lai as a close ally. In fact, they couldn't wait for Qin Lai and Black Voodoo Cult to fight each other to a bloody end and completely kill each other off. 10,000 Beast Mountain's Yu Min and Celestial Artifact Sex Feng Yu fell silent. It seemed like both of them were going to sit back and watch the farce happening before them play out. Qin Lai. Zhu Moyan walked forward without any warning. Upon seeing that Qin Lai was about to enter Black Voodoo Cult's domain by himself, even Wu Chen's face changed in color, and he subconsciously got to his feet. He believed that fighting would erupt at any moment and that he was obligated to take part in it since he had joined their group. Stay here, Zhu Moyan. Don't move. Sit back down, Wu Chen. Surprisingly, Song Tianyu and Du Ziyang Yang spoke up to dissuade Zhu Moyan and Wu Chen. They warned them not to follow Qin Lai, instead telling them to stay where they were. Zhu Moyan and Wu Chen looked at Du Ziyang Yang in confusion. Qin Lai is just one person. If he goes against Black Voodoo Cult alone, he'll be harmed immediately. Zhu Moyan said urgently. How can you people relax right now? Ban Kai and Qian exclaimed in a soft voice, steadily growing anxious. Isn't Qin Lai your friend? Are you going to just watch him throw his life away? Then she shot Song Tianyu a look of self-righteous anger. Especially you. How can you be like this? Song Tianyu pursed her lips into a smile and shook her head, refusing to give him an explanation. Qin Lai will be fine. Du Ziyang Yang lowered his voice, a stern expression on his face. No one can hurt Qin Lai in the Forbidden Land of Thunder. Just relax. Zhu Moyan and Luo Chen were both incredibly startled when Du Ziyang Yang said this. Neither of them could understand what he meant, their eyes full of confusion. Individuals that are evil remnants of Blood Fiend sect are the public enemies of every force in the Land of Chaos. The fact that you two dare to cultivate the Blood Spirit art means that you deserve to suffer everyone's attacks. This is undisputed truth whether you are in the Land of Chaos or the Graveyard of Gods. Su Yan shrieked. Let's kill the remnant evils of Blood Fiend sect first. Lin Dongxing expressed his thoughts in a simple fashion. Kill them all. Zhi Yuan exploded into a yell. Do you see this? Huang Zilai's beautiful face held a sinister shade, and her deep eyes hid unfathomable ripples of evil. Blood Fiend sect is, without a doubt, a public enemy. Since you are remnant evils of Blood Fiend sect, you probably understand what kind of treatment you'll face, right? You two no longer have a place in the Graveyard of Gods or the Land of Chaos. Is that so? Qin Lai continued to approach them. Not a single trace of anger could be seen on his face, and his eyes held an unnatural calm that gave people an eerie feeling. His aloof demeanor made even the martial practitioners of Black Voodoo Cult and the three great families feel anxious on the inside. Blood Fiend sect was the most ancient force in the Land of Chaos, just like Black Voodoo Cult. They fought each other for thousands of years, both in the open and behind the scenes, Qin Lai said indifferently. I naturally learned about the relationship and grudges between both sides. I know that Black Voodoo Cult spent a lot of effort in order to take down Blood Fiend sect. 1,000 years ago, when Blood Fiend sect's Zhang Zi began consuming human blood to fast-track his cultivation, it gave you the perfect excuse and opportunity to eliminate Blood Fiend sect. Of course, you of Black Voodoo Cult would never let go of a chance that only came once in a blue moon. The three great families, on the other hand, have always harbored rebellious intentions under Blood Fiend sect's rule. Qin Lai looked at Su Yan and the others. However, since Blood Fiend sect was strong, they didn't dare to act recklessly. Black Voodoo Cult's discovery gave the three great families hope, and both sides immediately got along well. Black Voodoo Cult summoned all the forces of the Land of Chaos together to invade the Heavenly Calamity Continent and denounce Blood Fiend sect. At the same time, the three great families cooperated with them from the inside and served as a guide. In the end, both sides got what they wanted, causing Blood Fiend sect's downfall. You knew that, out of all Blood Fiend sect's martial practitioners, only those under Zhang Zi cultivated the evil Blood Spirit art. Yet you pretended not to and instead treated all Blood Fiend sect martial practitioners as if they were evil bloodsuckers. Do you really think that no one knew what you were thinking? After slowly revealing secrets from 1,000 years ago, Qin Lai smiled and candidly said, Unfortunately, you failed to eliminate every blood fiend sect martial practitioner. Not only is Zhang Zhe still alive. He paused at that moment and abruptly looked at Celestial Artifact Sect Feng Yu. A strange expression covered Feng Yu's face. The core members of Blood Fiend Sect are in hiding, alive and well. Even Blood Fiend Sect Master Zhu Li continues to exist in this world. Qin Lai stopped walking. He currently stood in front of Huang Zilai and was only a dozen or so meters away from the rest of the Black Voodoo Cult martial practitioners. Blood Fiend Sect was never truly destroyed. I can guarantee you that Blood Fiend Sect will soon awaken in the Land of Chaos once more. Qin Lai pointed at Su Yan's group and smiled coldly. Blood Fiend Sect will step on the corpses of the three great families and rise again. Kill him now. Zai Yuan roared angrily. Senior sister. Yi Hao's narrowed eyes were gleaming with an icy light. He had truly been angered. Qin Lai was being excessively arrogant. He had walked in front of Black Voodoo Cult's people and even insulted them, finger pointed at their faces. He had taunted them, threatening to eliminate the three great families. Never had he seen such an arrogant person before. How could they possibly endure such a farce? What do you say? Do you want to join us in eliminating remnant evils of Blood Fiend Sect? Huang Zilai turned her head and swept her gaze across the martial practitioners of Celestial Artifact Sect, 10,000 Beast Mountain, and Terminator Sect. She also looked at Luo Chen and Du Ziyang Yang. Luo Chen and Du Ziyang Yang kept themselves busy by talking to Song Tinu and Zhu Muyan. They didn't even spare so much as a glance for Huang Zilai. They clearly didn't give a damn about her. Feng Yu and Yu Men looked at each other, silent. They also chose to ignore Huang Zilai. Both of them couldn't believe how much of a joke this was. Just a few days ago, Qin Lai had charged into the middle of Celestial Artifact Sect and 10,000 Beast Mountain's martial practitioners. He had drawn thunder and lightning from the sky, raining them down on them and chasing them as they fled. That pitiful, terrifying memory was still fresh in their heads like it had happened yesterday, so why on earth would they take part in a battle against Qin Lai? Furthermore, Qin Lai already stood right in front of Huang Zilai. He was probably planning to attract thunder and lightning to fall from the sky, heavily damaging Black Voodoo Cult just like he had damaged their forces. Yu Men and Feng Yu couldn't wait for Black Voodoo Cult to suffer the same pain and suffering that they had, so there was no way they would interfere at such a crucial moment. As a result, both Celestial Artifact Sect and 10,000 Beast Mountain had fallen silent. The remnant evils of Blood Fiend Sect do deserve to be eliminated. Surprisingly, He Wei was the first to speak up, actually agreeing with Huang Zilai. Huang Zilai's eyes lit up. Every martial practitioner of Black Voodoo Cult and the three great families had looks of astonishment on their faces. Terminator Sect actually agreed with them. Back in the Forbidden Land of Wood, Terminator Sect had obviously been close to Qin Lai, having formed the most solid of alliances in a graveyard of gods. No one could have imagined that Terminator Sect would actually end up hating Qin Lai in just half a month's time in the Forbidden Land of Thunder. Life was truly fickle. Shut up. For the very first time, Zhu Li loudly scolded He Wei in front of everyone. Don't you have a damn brain? If you plan on making all the decisions, get out of my team. You're telling me to leave? He Wei couldn't help but scream in response. Ask Ran Peng, Hu Ping, and Wei Liang who they trust more, you or me? Whose orders will you three follow? Zhu Li shouted irritably. Everyone froze. No one could have foreseen that Terminator Sect would experience internal strife at such a pivotal moment. Even Zhu Li, who had been treating He Wei favorably all this time, had suddenly exploded and lost control for some reason. Every martial practitioner of every force subconsciously looked at the members of Terminator Sect, specifically Zhu Li and He Wei. All of them were shocked. Since Qin Lai had moved in front of Huang Zilai, he could also see the conflict between He Wei and Zhu Li. We follow your orders, senior brother. There's no doubt about that, however. Regarding Qin Lai, we believe that Sister He's words make sense. Ren Peng had to force himself to get the words out. What about you two? Zhu Li sucked in a deep breath, his expression gloomy like swampy water. We are of the same opinion, Hu Ping and Wei Liang said in unison, their heads bowed. Now do you see, Zhu? He Wei smiled coldly. Blood Fiend Sect was always a public enemy in the first place. Or am I wrong for some reason? This is all your fault. He never thought of you as a brother. If he did, why would he force you to compete with him for the Pure Soul Springs? Why would he summon everyone here to prevent us from even getting any leftovers? He Wei was upset because Qin Lai had turned them away, then summoned Black Voodoo Cult, Celestial Artifact Sect, 10,000 Beast Mountain, and Illusory Demon Sect without asking for their opinion. If Qin Lai had just broke through the Thunder Barrier and entered the Thunder Lagoon, they could have at least shared the Pure Soul Springs equally. Qin Lai's actions had shattered all of their sweet dreams. His actions prevented He Wei from seeing even the tiniest bit of hope and led to hatred blossoming in her heart. Good. Very good. How very good you are. Zhu Li laughed in grief, and nodding continuously. You're also awesome, aren't you? Fine then. Do what you want. From now on, in the Graveyard of Gods, and even when we've returned to the Land of Chaos, we walk separate paths. With this declaration, Zhu Li turned and walked away under everyone's gazes. He had actually given up on the struggle for the Pure Soul Springs.